Today I am with a fellow magical practitioner here in the Philippines, and let me bring it on air. And what is your name?
I'm Alvin Lasquety Sentin, and then also known as Lakay Alsent, Magbaya, Aghama.
Okay, Lakay Alsent, how long or since when did you start practicing magic in the Philippines?
I'm starting practicing magical workings or self-dedication into magic is since 1996.
So from 1996, you are practicing magic. So what kind of magic you are practicing in your life?
I'm doing a simple prayer with a candle lightning. And then year 2003, I guess, I'm mixing my practices with a Christopagan practices. So I use Latin words as a prayer, and then using basic herbs and candles.
Okay, so how do you become a magical practitioner? So that practice, where did you learn from that magical practices in your life?
Okay, so since childhood, I'm interested into magical workings or into the spirit realm. And then since childhood, I found some things from my father. They called it how to open the third eye. So from that, that's the that time that my curiosity comes out. So I search more. So I'm starting to ask my grandfather, and then my father, my mother, and then they teach me some basic prayer, and then some basic belief like don't do this, or if you want to attract positivity or good luck, you need to bring this one, or you need to put this in your pocket.
So mostly the magical practice you learn is from your family. So do you consider yourself as a traditional witch or family lineage witch?
I guess I'm blessed for being a natural practitioners, but I believe also that all of us has the same practices. So they they mix it in a Christian way or Christian belief.
So basically you are practicing Christian mysticism. But what about Wicca? Have you heard about Wicca here in the Philippines?
Yes, my first encounter in Wicca is since 2003 with my classmate, and then my buddy since high school.
So have you been practicing Wicca since then, or did you involve yourself in practicing Wicca?
Okay, that time I'm practicing basic Wicca, and then so I mix the Christopagan and then the basic Wicca. So in what form or in what way, I'm just using the directions, the four element, the quarters, then I use circle casting before like that, because based on our Philippine tradition, there's no circle casting, but they use elements. So I decided in 2003 to mix them, and there's no problem for doing them both. So if you're asking me if I'm doing Wicca, I guess my practice is also a Wiccan or eclectic Wiccan, because I believe in a natural law, and then the golden rule of a Wicca, which is any harm none do at you will, like that, and then I follow that law.
Prior become a magical practitioner and as a Wicca, what is your religion before?
I was born as a Roman Catholic.
Then what makes you change your religion or embrace the magical path?
I guess in my curiosity. So I'm curious in the darkness, in the elements, because when I grow up, most of my family, they talk some spirits, encantos, elementals, nature spirit. So in that way, parang nag-start na ako mag-question.
You start to question on things about the existence of those supernatural, invisible,
yes.
And you try to dig deeper and study more on those things which Wicca and magic could only answer, right?
Yes, sort of, yeah.
sort of. So with regards to that, we all know that Wicca is a religion that practices and teach magic to society. So what would you, in your own opinion, what do you think about the benefit of Wicca? Is it good or is it bad?
The benefit of a Wicca is it's like being neutral, and then you need to know the cause and effect and be ready in every actions of your life or in every action that you choose like that. And then for me, being a Wicca or accepting the practices of a Wicca is being responsible all the time. So I guess it's always it's more on neutral practice.
So here in the Philippine Global Summit, Philippine Global Summit, we are trying to search that or to justify that Wicca as a global religion. Since for us as a Correllian, we believe that Wicca is a religion. Like other religion, it has structures, it has doctrines, it has practices. And as we all know here in the Philippines, most of the religion, the present or current modern religion here, came here in the Philippines with a missionary or with a preacher. Who do you think, on your part, who do you think introduces Wicca here in the Philippines? So how you get introduced into the magical art, aside from the ancient or the traditional family lineage, who do you think introduces Wicca here in the Philippines, and how?
In my experiences, I guess through books by Raymond Buckland and Silver Ribbon Wolf, because in my years, every time I go to a national bookstores, I found some book that explains about Wiccan. And then the author was Raymond Buckland or Silver Raven Wolf.
So it is true book. So is there any actual, do you remember that, is there any actual person that came here in the Philippines and start teaching Wicca and converting people into Wiccan religion?
I guess I don't encounter any practitioner here in the Philippines aside you.
But how was it? How is the practice of Wicca here in the Philippines? As we can see online, there are many people that claims that they are practicing Wicca.
I also remember there's another group that I've encountered, the PGWS, the Philippine Wiccan Society. I think I go there gathering once, but based on my experiences, it's hard for me to understand their practices because most of the time they have their own practices and title, like eclectic witches, Wiccan warlock. So that time is I don't have any idea for the terms, but that time also they don't push to study or to be fixed in one system or in one religion. So they just like more on do what you want, practice what you want, like that.
But how in your opinion, how deep is the faith of the Filipino people in practicing Wicca? Because in the United States or in other part of the world, Wicca is a religion. They have a church that they provide services such as hand fasting, Wiccaning ritual, funeral rites. Is there any church here, a Wiccan church here in the Philippines that provide those services, such as if you are a Wiccan couple and want to get married, is there a Wiccan church? Or from the organizations that you know right now, is there a church that provides those services for their Wiccan members?
Aside from Luntiang Aghama, I never found any groups that offer and teach Wiccan or Wicca practices here in the Philippines. So I guess the Luntiang Aghama is the one who has the ability and capable to do and to teach Wiccan and to do some rituals for like hand fasting
or legal marriages.
So
in your opinion, in your personal life, how do you see Wicca here in the Philippines? How do you see Wicca in 10 years from now here in the Philippines?
Honestly, I want to see Wicca here in the Philippines as a big and has a big and solid foundation here in the Philippines that can do some ritual, especially the Sabbath, legally. And I'm looking forward also in other practitioner that they gather and do some Sabbath monthly or every Sabbath, because in this time, in this moment, let's say hindi we're not ano, we don't act as a one.
Divided.
Yeah, divided. By we're interest. Always divided by personal interest, by ego, by pride, like that. So I'm hoping to break that that problem.
One more question: what would you advise? What would you advise to the seekers of the crop who want to explore the knowledge in witchcraft? What will be the safest thing to do, or how will they find Wicca here? Yes, for the seekers, what would you advise them to do?
For the seeker, the true essence of Wicca is being yourself, being a part of a nature, which is you need to be part of a nature. It means that every time you do or every actions that you there's a growth in every actions that we take, like nature. So no need to block, or it's like a crab mentality
to drag down other people.
So it's like unity, responsibility, harmony, organize.
In order to have progress, they should be responsible, giving respect to one another.
Yes, and practicing Wicca also, I want to clear this one, that this is not about black magic and white magic or being a powerful. This is being your, it's the essence of life, how to be joyful, how to maintain yourself, your connection to your higher self, to your divinity, and to the divinity of others.
Okay, thank you, Lakay Alsent Magbaya Aghama. And from the shrine of Luntiang Aghama, this is Apodman for the Philippine Global Weekend Summit. May you all, blessed be peace, mayari na, pag-asatin.